Ultimately, martial art means honestly expressing yourself.
Everybody, how you doing today? Here I am in Chinatown in Los Angeles, California. Hope you're doing well. I'm doing a video today on Bruce Lee. I watched Enter the Dragon probably over 400 times. I used to work in a video store. We watched three movies, Aladdin in the morning, Forrest Gump in the afternoon, and Enter the Dragon at night. So literally, I've seen this movie a lot. I'm very excited, as you can tell. I get very excited about certain things, and Bruce Lee is one of them. And right here is his former dojo. It's now reopened. I don't know if it's open right now, but this is where it is. I'm very excited. I'm gonna take a look. And here is the dojo right here, yeah. Very, very cool. And it's reopened. So it was closed for 50 years, and apparently it reopened as a dojo. But it's now a shared artist space, and where they, like an artist collective, where they, a bunch of different owners of businesses, like artwork, clothing, come and work on their products. So it's no longer a dojo, but it still kind of looks like a dojo inside. Do you want to go inside? Yeah? Okay, let's go inside.
Bruce Lee owned and operated the studio from 1967 until 1969, and then it was various businesses for quite a while, and then remained vacant for 18 years. Now, in November of 2019, Eric Carr, who was a student of Jerry Poteet, one of Bruce Lee's main students, reopened the studio for once-a-month classes. I'm not quite sure if that's still happening. And here's some pictures of Bruce Lee in that studio. The second picture right here, that's opening day, and that's Bruce Lee there in the back in the black.
So right there, that's it. That's 628 College Street here in Chinatown. That's where Bruce Lee taught Jeet Kune Do, right in there, which is crazy. I'm shocked. I thought it was still a dojo. It's not, but it's right here. We were inside, you and me. Now we're gonna go see something else really, really, really cool about Bruce Lee that's just around the corner. And then we're going somewhere really cool about Bruce Lee. All right, I don't wanna leave. When I come to a place like this with so much history, I don't wanna leave. But time is of the essence and we must go. Let's go. If you're at Bruce Lee's dojo, you're just gonna walk down College Street to Hill Street, make a left. And I believe the statue should be, I've actually never seen it before, but I know it's right in the heart, and you can enter off of Broadway. But I should be able to get there through this entranceway on Hill Street. Although I overshot my thinking somewhat, so to speak, because I didn't realize that I have to cross here without a light. But that is what I'll do. We're gonna run together. We're gonna run together. We're running. We're running. And we ran. This is really cool. The statue should be right down here, I think. It's gonna do this in real time. See what it's pretty cool. Where's the statue? Okay, should be down, probably down this way. And they shot a scene from Pretty in Pink in here. Just add that in. The statue should be right around here somewhere. And there we are. That's gonna be the statue right there. Beautiful, beautiful Chinatown. And this is just right at the entranceway. I believe this is called Sun Moon Way, I think. Wow. Look at that. And it reads, Bruce Lee's Statue Project is a community initiative aimed at celebrating the life and legacy of Bruce Lee through the placement of a statue in Los Angeles Chinatown. Bruce Lee's contributions to martial arts and action films were truly innovative. More importantly, however, Bruce Lee was an Asian American pioneer who changed our cultural landscape by breaking down racial barriers and creating a personal philosophy that continues to inspire millions of people the world over. And that's so true, because I get asked about Bruce Lee, doing stuff about Bruce Lee all the time. All ages, all sorts of people all over the world write in the comments or on my live chats asking me to do something about Bruce Lee. And I've been to his grave, which is humbling. That's on my channel, and this is crazy. I've driven along here many times, but this blocks it, so I've never really actually seen it. Here we are.
I think everybody knows a little bit about Bruce Lee. I'm going to give a brief biography of him right now. He was born in San Francisco, but he grew up in Hong Kong. He was introduced to the entertainment industry at an early age, as his father was an opera singer and part-time actor. The younger Bruce Lee began appearing in films as a child and was frequently cast as a juvenile delinquent or a street urchin. As a teenager, he took up with local gangs and began learning kung fu to better defend himself. At that time, he also started dance lessons, which further refined his footwork and balance. In 1958, Bruce Lee won the Hong Kong Cha-Cha Championship. Bruce Lee's parents were increasingly disturbed by his street fighting and run-ins with the police, so they sent him to live in the United States with family friends in Seattle shortly after he turned 18. It was here where he finished high school and studied philosophy and drama at the University of Washington. While in Seattle, he opened his first martial arts school, and in 1964, he relocated to Oakland, California to found a second school. It was about that time that he developed his own technique, Jeet Kune Do, a blend of ancient kung fu, fencing, boxing, and philosophy, which he began teaching instead of traditional martial arts. He drew the attention kung fu demonstration at a Los Angeles area karate tournament, and he was cast as a sidekick Kato in the television series The Green Hornet. Lee had difficulty finding acting jobs after the cancellation of The Green Hornet, and he began supplementing his income by giving private Jeet Kune Do lessons to Hollywood stars, including Steve McQueen. In the 1969 film Marlowe, Lee received notice for a scene in which he destroyed an entire office through kickboxing and karate moves. Troubled by his inability to find other suitable roles, however, he moved back to Hong Kong in 1961. There, Bruce Lee starred in two films that broke box office records throughout Asia, and he later found success in the United States with Tang Shan Dong Xiang, Fist of Fury, or The Big Boss, and then The Chinese Connection, also known as Fist of Fury. That was the Hong Kong English title. Then Bruce used his sudden box office clout to form his own production company, and he co-produced, directed, wrote, and starred in his next film, Return of the Dragon. His following film, Enter the Dragon, was the first joint venture between Hong Kong and US-based production companies, and it became a worldwide hit, thrusting Lee into international movie stardom. Tragically, he died 6 days before the film's Hong Kong release. The mysterious circumstances of his death were a source of speculation for fans and historians, but the cause of death was officially listed as swelling of the brain caused by an allergic reaction to a headache medication. At the time, Lee had been working on a film called Game of Death, which was pieced together with stand-ins and cardboard cutouts of Lee's face, and was released in 1978.
I should mention that there's a pretty famous photo of Michael Jackson with Bruce Lee. It's not real, it's photoshopped. Bruce Lee died in 1973 and Michael Jackson was 15 in 1973 and he didn't look quite the same. Here's the real picture with Christie Brinkley.
It's incredible up close, just wild. People have left some things here. Oh, so he left a rock. Yeah. Really cool. All right, we're going somewhere else having to do with Bruce Lee. Something. All right, we're gonna go somewhere else having to do with Bruce Lee right now. And there it is. Famous Bruce Lee statue here in Chinatown in Los Angeles. Before we leave Chinatown, I just thought you should see this. This is just absolutely, absolutely beautiful. Wow. All right, so right now we're walking through a house that was owned by Bruce Lee from about 1967 to 1968. Big shout out to Sean from All About Los Angeles. You've seen him in my videos before. You'll see him in some more. This is Bruce Lee's former house right here. He owned this house when he opened the Dojo, I believe, over in Chinatown. And yeah, this is really, really cool to see it. And you can line up a couple of shots with the background right here. Of he was doing like a workout in the front, on the front lawn. And somebody's dropping a medicine ball on him. Seems like a good workout right here. So that's his house right there. This was Bruce Lee's house. Isn't that crazy? And if you come right along here, that's the famous lawn with the brick wall in the background. So he's posing right about right there. Isn't that cool? I'll insert a shot of Sean when he posed on the front lawn right now. Really cool. You should follow allaboutlosangeles.com on Instagram and his website. Lots of cool stuff. But there you go, that's Bruce Lee's house. One of them. I'll do a part two someday and get some more houses because he owned a lot of property around Los Angeles. So this tiny little street over in Culver City, Bruce Lee used to drive up and down it, I'm assuming. Look at that, welcome home. Somebody's coming home to that house. It's a nice little house, great area. And that's my video about Bruce Lee. All right, thanks for watching. Bruce Lee, rest in peace. Brandon Lee, of course, rest in peace as well. And all of you, thanks for watching, peace. What are you looking at? Peace.